इन द नेम ऑफ अल्लाह द बेनिफिशेंट द मर्सीफुल। अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, आवर टुडेज लेक्चर इज अबाउट लिक्विड जंक्शन पोटेंशियल एंड इलेक्ट्रॉन ट्रांसफर रिएक्शन। इट इज़ अनदर लेक्चर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोकेमिस्ट्री, BS 6th semester physical chemistry. We will discuss about the liquid junction potential here, its calculation, its elimination, and then we will talk about the electron transfer reaction and then electron transfer reactions in some complexes. They follow two type of the mechanism. One is inner sphere mechanism and second one is outer sphere mechanism. And then Marcus theory to explain outer sphere mechanism. Liquid junction potential. Students, when we talk about concentration cells, here a cell is shown with the two different concentration. On the left hand side, activity of a cell is A1. It is greater than that of the right hand side cell, where the activity of a cell is A2. A2 is lower than that of A1. Whenever we talk about this type of cells, a liquid junction potential arises there at the junction of two liquids or two solutions. It is due to the difference in the movement of the positively charged and negatively charged electron ions. For example, here H positive and chloride ions are there. The H positive and chloride ions will move from the higher concentration towards the lower concentration, and if one of the ion would have the greater speed or greater mobility than that of the other ion, it would move faster, leaving the charge behind. For example, here in this example, if the mobility of chloride ions is greater, they will move rapidly towards the right hand side solution, and there will be a net negative charge on the right hand side solution and net positive charge on the left hand side solution due to the accumulation of more positive charges there, while the negative charges are passed through the membrane towards the right hand side. So the negative charge on the right hand side and positive charge on the left hand side will make a double charged layer here at this position at the junction of two solutions. This will be called as liquid junction potential, and this is due to the difference in between the mobilities or diffusion rates or movement of the ions, which are moving from the higher concentration towards the lower concentration. Here the explanation is, if we suppose that anions are moving with the more speed than that of the cations, then this situation would arise. The positive charge will be there at the solution from where the ions are moving, and negative charge will appear at the solution where the ions are going. This potential is called as liquid junction potential because it is produced at the junction of two liquids. Liquid junction potential, or it is also called to be a diffusion potential, which is a non-equilibrium potential, because equilibrium is not maintained here. Whenever the movement takes place, the magnitude of the potential depends on the relative speeds of the ions movement, and whenever this relative speed is higher, this magnitude would become greater, and when relative speeds are lower, this magnitude will be lower. Liquid junction potential can be easily calculated. Liquid junction potential arises due to the difference of mobilities of positive and negative ions. Their relative speeds can be determined, and their relative speed actually determine the magnitude of the liquid junction potential. If oppositely charged ions have same mobilities, same speeds, they are moving with the same speed, there will be the zero value of this liquid junction potential. Direct measurement of liquid junction potential is not possible, but it can be calculated. How we can calculate? It is calculated by taking the two type of EMF. The EMF of a cell is taken without transport number, where the ions have not moved, ions are not moving across the boundary. Then we take the EMF of the cell, and then we would take the EMF of the cell with transport number, means by considering in the upper one cell diagram. When we consider the movement of ions, it will be called as with transport number, and when we have blockage here and we do not allow the ions to pass, that one will be called as विदाउट और विदाउट यूजिंग द ट्रांसपोर्ट नंबर. द फर्स्ट वन पोटेंशियल इज टेकन विदाउट एनी ट्रांसपोर्ट नंबर. द सेकेंड वन पोटेंशियल इज टेकन विद ट्रांसपोर्ट नंबर. हेयर ए वन एंड ए टू आर द एक्टिविटीज ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रोलाइट एच सी एल. वी हैव टॉक्ड अबाउट ए वन इज द एक्टिविटी ऑफ द लेफ्ट हैंड साइड सेल एंड ए टू इज द एक्टिविटी इन द राइट हैंड साइड सेल. आर इज द जनरल गैस कॉन्स्टेंट. हेयर टी इज द टेम्परेचर इन केल्विन. एफ इज टेकन टू बी अ फैराडेज कॉन्स्टेंट. एल एन इज अ नेचुरल लॉग फॉर विच द बेस इज टेकन टू बी ई. एंड देन इफ वी टेक द ट्रांसपोर्ट नंबर वी वुड टेक अनदर ई एम एफ वैल्यू. टी एम हेयर इज द ट्रांसपोर्ट नंबर वैल्यू. आर टी एफ ए टू एंड ए वन वी हैव एक्सप्लेन्ड अर्लियर. द डिफरेंस बिटवीन दीज टू वैल्यूज ऑफ ई एम एफ वेन एवर वी वुड सब्ट्रैक्ट ई एम एफ विदाउट ट्रांसपोर्ट नंबर एंड ई एम एफ विद ट्रांसपोर्ट नंबर. द ई एम एफ विदाउट ट्रांसपोर्ट नंबर विल बी सब्ट्रैक्टेड फ्रॉम ई एम एफ विद ट्रांसपोर्ट नंबर. वी वुड गेट द वैल्यू फॉर लिक्विड जंक्शन पोटेंशियल. द लिक्विड जंक्शन पोटेंशियल कैन बी कैलकुलेटेड बाई द डिफरेंस ऑफ दीज टू ई एम एफ. इट कैन नॉट बी फाउंड डायरेक्टली बट इट कैन बी कैलकुलेटेड फ्रॉम दीज टू वैल्यूज. साइन एंड मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ लिक्विड जंक्शन पोटेंशियल डिपेंड्स अपॉन द ट्रांसफर नंबर ऑफ आयंस विच इज कॉल्ड टू बी ए ट्रांसपोर्ट नंबर एज वेल. एंड देर आर थ्री कंडीशंस. इफ ट्रांसपोर्ट नंबर ऑफ केट आयंस बिकम्स इक्वल टू द ट्रांसपोर्ट नंबर ऑफ एन आयंस द लिक्विड जंक्शन पोटेंशियल वुड हैव जीरो वैल्यू. इफ द ट्रांसपोर्ट नंबर ऑफ एन आयन इज ग्रेटर देन दैट ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्ट नंबर ऑफ केट आयन द लिक्विड जंक्शन हैव पॉजिटिव वैल्यू एंड द नेट ई एम एफ ऑफ द सेल विल बी टेकन बाई एडिंग दिस ई एम एफ लिक्विड जंक्शन पोटेंशियल ई एम एफ इन टू दैट वन ई एम एफ. एंड इफ केटाइन नंबर इज ग्रेटर देन दैट ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्ट नंबर ऑफ केटाइन इज ग्रेटर देन दैट ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्ट नंबर ऑफ एन आइन देन द लिक्विड जंक्शन पोटेंशियल वुड हैव अ नेगेटिव वैल्यू एंड द नेट ई एम एफ ऑफ द सेल विल बी टेकन आफ्टर सब्ट्रैक्टिंग दिस वैल्यू फ्रॉम दैट वन. Elimination of liquid junction potential. How a liquid junction potential can be removed? In the upper one equation, we have taken that whenever you take a gauze in between the two cells which have different concentration, the ions move from higher concentration to the lower concentration. If we change this concept by using the salt bridge, what is the salt bridge? Salt bridge is a U-shaped tube which is used to connect the two solution, and it is often filled with that of the salt, and salt solution is made in agarose gel. It is also called to be agar-agar gel, and the solution of the salt is prepared in it, and the salts selected are like KCl, ammonium nitrate, etc. These are the salts for which the mobilities of cation and mobility of anions are almost equal to each other. So this type of salts are selected, and the use of salt bridge eliminates the liquid junction potential because towards the both side of the cell where the accumulation of negative charge take place, where the accumulation of positive charge take place, these ions move to their respective positions to make the solution neutral with the same speed, and liquid junction potential is made zero. So liquid junction potential is eliminated by the salt bridge in concentration cells. Electron transfer reaction. These are the simply redox reaction. We have talked about the redox reaction. We have talked about copper zinc cell, galvanic cell, voltaic cell, etc. And then we have talked about the electrolysis process in electrolytic cell. In all those reactions, redox reactions take place and oxidation reduction reaction take place. And I am not going to discuss about those simple reactions in which like zinc is giving electron to the copper, or we say that copper is taking electron from SHE. In similar way, zinc was giving electron to SHE and zinc was oxidized. We have taken the oxidation potential of zinc. All these reactions involve the electron transfer reaction, and these are the simple reactions to discuss about in chemistry or electrochemistry. But here we would talk about the electron transfer reactions which take place in complexes. Electron transfer reaction is the reaction in which an electron is transferred from one atom or molecule to such type of the entity, and this electron transfer actually a pathway of a redox reaction, wherein the oxidation state of the reactants and products changes. One works as an oxidant, its oxidation state decreases. The second one works as a reductant, its oxidation state increases. Numerous biological processes involve this type of reaction. These electron transfer reactions take place in many number of biological processes. These processes include oxygen binding, photosynthesis process, respiration, detoxification, etc. These are the biological reactions in which electron transfer take place. Additionally, the process of energy transfer can be formalized as a two electron exchange in case of small distances between the transferring molecules, where there are small distances between the transferring molecules, like proteins or metals entrapped in proteins are there, and when their electron transfer take place, the process involves some energy transfer as well. Actually, two concurrent electron transfer events take place in opposite directions here. Electron transfer reactions commonly involve transition metal complexes, but there are now many examples of electron transfer reactions in organic chemistry as well. Mostly they involve in transition metal complexes, but in organic chemistry there are many examples as well. In a heterogeneous electron transfer, an electron moves. It is another type of electron transfer reaction where an electron moves from a species to the solid state electrode. Theories addressing heterogeneous electron transfer have applications in electrochemistry. In electrochemistry, usually we talk about the electron exchange in between the solution and that of the electrodes. This type of electron transfer reactions are called as heterogeneous electron transfer reactions. Electron transfer reactions, and here we are going to talk about inner sphere mechanism. When we have complexes, there is a part which is taken in a square bracket will be called as sphere, coordination sphere, and this inner sphere mechanism is a type of mechanism in which a change take place in that one coordination sphere. Inner sphere electron transfer or bonded electron transfer is a redox chemical reaction that proceeds via a covalent linkage. Here a covalent linkage takes place between a oxidant and reductant, and electron is transferred from that covalent linkage, where a strong electronic interaction is formed between the oxidant and reductant reactants. The inner sphere electron transfer, a ligand bridge the two metal redox centers. One metal is a oxidant, second one metal is a reductant. A ligand makes a bridging between two metals during the electron transfer event. Inner sphere reactions are inhibited by large ligand. Whenever there are large ligands involved, these reactions do not take place because the bridging would not take place. So this type of reactions do not occur in bulky protein like materials where the metal ions are shielded by bulky proteins. This type of mechanism will not be there. Inner sphere electron transfer is usually used to describe reactions involving transition metal complexes. However, redox centers can consist up of organic moieties, organic groups, rather than that of the metal centers as well. This type of reaction would take place in this type of complexes where the ligands are not bulky. The bridging ligand must have more number of electron pairs, more number of lone pairs of electrons, in order to bridge with the two metals at a time. Bridging ligand could be an entity that can convey electron. It conveys electron from a reductant to oxidant. Typically, such a ligand has more than one lone pair of electrons, such that it can serve as an electron donor to both the reductant and the oxidant. We have taken that it must have more than one lone pair of electrons so that it can make bridge with that of the two metals, which is an oxidant and second one is a reductant. कॉमन ब्रिजिंग लिगेंड्स इंक्लूड्स द हेलाइड्स एंड द सूडो हेलाइड्स, हाइड्रोक्साइड्स, थायोसाइनेट्स. मोर कॉम्प्लेक्स ब्रिजिंग लिगेंड्स आर ऑल्सो वेल नोन, इंक्लूडिंग ऑक्सलेट्स, मेलोनेट्स एंड पायरेजिन्स एट्सेट्रा. दीज आर फ्यू एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ दीज ब्रिजिंग लिगेंड्स. बिफोर द इलेक्ट्रॉन ट्रांसफर टू टेक प्लेस द ब्रिज्ड कॉम्प्लेक्स मस्ट फॉर्म एंड सच प्रोसेसेज आर ऑफन हाईली रिवर्सिबल. इलेक्ट्रॉन ट्रांसफर अकर थ्रू द ब्रिज वंस इट इज एस्टेब्लिश्ड. अ ब्रिज, एन इंटरमीडिएट इज फॉर्म्ड वेयर अ लिगेंड मेक्स अ ब्रिज बिटवीन द टू मेटल. इन सम केसेज स्टेबल ब्रिज स्ट्रक्चर्स आर फॉर्म्ड, वाइल इन अदर केसेज दीज इंटरमीडिएट्स आर ट्रांजिशन स्टेट्स एंड दीज आर not stable to much extent. Here we explain the mechanism. Henry Tobey discovered this inner sphere mechanism and got a Nobel Prize in 1983. He was actually working on these two complexes. One is of chromium and the other one is of cobalt complex. Here cobalt is in plus 3 oxidation state, while the second one complex is a chromium complex, hexa-aqua chromium complex, where the chromium is in plus 2 oxidation state. Here chromium is in plus 2 oxidation state, while cobalt is in plus 3 oxidation state in the reactants. He has carried out this reaction in a medium containing radioactive chlorine, and only 0.5% that radioactive chlorine became the part of this chromium 3. It means that the chlorine which appears with that of the chromium in the product is transferred from cobalt towards the chromium. It is not taken from the medium. Again, listen that the medium contains radioactive chlorine. It means that if this chromium which does not have chlorine in the reactant form, if it carries this chlorine from the medium, this chlorine must be radioactive chlorine. But on analysis, it was shown that only 0.5% this chlorine was taken from the medium. It means that this chlorine is transferred from the cobalt complex towards the chromium complex. It means inner sphere reaction is taken place. The sphere composition is, coordination sphere composition is changed. Here in this coordination sphere there was chlorine, but here in this coordination sphere there is water instead of chlorine. Above can be described with the following equation. Here in this equation, cobalt from plus 3 oxidation state moves to plus 2 oxidation state. It means reduced, and it works as an oxidant. It has oxidized chromium from plus 2 to plus 3. The point of interest in the chloride is that the chloride that was originally bonded with that of the cobalt, and cobalt is working as an oxidant, becomes bonded to chromium like this way, and it transfers electron from chromium towards cobalt. Chromium becomes plus 3 oxidation state, while cobalt comes into plus 2 oxidation state instead of plus 3. So chloride is working as a bridging ligand here. It transfers an electron from chromium towards cobalt and then joins chromium. It becomes a part of coordination sphere with that of chromium. The observation implies the formation of intermediate as a bimetallic complex. This is a bimetallic complex formation. Mu stands for bridging chlorine. Mu Cl indicates that the chlorine bridges between the chromium and cobalt atom, serving as a ligand for both. The chloride serves as a conduit for electron flow from, actually it is a medium through which an electron moves from chromium towards cobalt. Chromium from 2 to 3 oxidation state, and cobalt goes from 3 to 2 oxidation state. Cobalt is reduced and chromium is oxidized here. Outer sphere mechanism. It is a type of mechanism where there will be no change in the coordination sphere and electron is transferred. And this transfer of electron usually take place between the same type of species, between two same metal atoms, just different in the oxidation state. Electron transfer event in contrast with the inner sphere electron transfer, the participating redox sites undergoing electron transfer become connected by a chemical bridge. Here covalent bridging does not take place, it's a chemical bridge which joins the two sides. Because the electron transfer in outer sphere electron transfer occurs between two non-connected species, the electron is forced to move through the space. These are not connected by the bonds, so electrons which are transferred from one species to the other species, these are through the space or through the solution. Outer sphere electron transfer can occur between chemical species that are identical. Both are manganese atoms, but they differ in oxidation state. Here manganese is in plus 7 oxidation state, but here the manganese is in plus 6 oxidation state. The process is termed as self-exchange process. The example is the degenerate reactions between the tetrahedral ions permanganate and magnate. Permanganate and magnate, electron is transferred from magnate to permanganate. Manganese electron is transferred from this one manganese to this manganese, from manganese star to this simple manganese. For octahedral complexes, the rate constant for self-exchange reactions correlates with the change in population of EG. There are two type of orbital, T2G, triply degenerate, three orbitals are here, DXY, DYZ, DXZ, and EG. These are the DX square, Y square, and DZ square orbitals. These are at above higher energy in octahedral complexes, and these three have the lower energy. He says that here in octahedral complexes, the mechanism correlates with that of the population here at EG orbital. For example, in this type of reactions where cobalt from plus 1 to plus 2 oxidation state of cobalt from plus 1 to plus 2, and electron is transferred from here to this one species, here there will be no population change in that of EG, so the rate of self-exchange reaction is much higher, that is 10 to the power 9 per mole per second. But whenever you talk about this type of complex where the electronic configuration was T2G5 EG2 and it becomes T2G6 EG0, here the electron transfer is much lower and the rate of electron transfer is only 18 per mole per second. This outer sphere mechanism is explained by the Marcus theory. There are two main points of the Marcus theory to explain the outer sphere electron transfer reaction. This theory was given Rudolf A. Marcus in 1950. According to this theory, a major aspect of Marcus theory is the dependence of electron transfer rate on the thermodynamic driving force. What does mean by this thermodynamic driving force? It means that the reactants stability and the product stability. There is a difference in the redox potential between reductant and oxidant species which are taking part in the reaction or electron exchanging sites. This driving force, which is the difference between the redox potentials, would carry out this type of reaction. If this driving force is greater or higher, the reaction rate will be higher. A second aspect of the rate of the outer sphere electron transfer depends inversely on the reorganizational energy. Reorganizational energy means from one complex form to the second one complex form, whenever electron change take place, the changes in bond lengths and changes in bond angles would take place. How much these bond angles in the products favors the stability of the product, this will be called as reorganizational energy. This reorganizational energy, if lower, the rate of this electron transfer will be higher, and if this reorganizational energy is higher, the rate of electron transfer reaction would become slower. This energy is assessed by the measurement of the self-exchange rates आउटर स्फीयर इलेक्ट्रॉन ट्रांसफर इज द मोस्ट कॉमन टाइप ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रॉन ट्रांसफर विच टेक प्लेस इन ऑल द बायोकेमिस्ट्री एंड बायोमोलिक्यूल्स, बिकॉज बायोमोलिक्यूल्स द लिगेंड्स आर इन मच लार्जर इन साइज वेयर द इनर ट्रांसफर मैकेनिज्म इनर स्फीयर मैकेनिज्म इज नॉट पॉसिबल. सो इन ऑर्डर टू एक्सप्लेन दिस टाइप ऑफ रिएक्शंस वी वुड हैव दिस टाइप ऑफ मैकेनिज्म. आउटर ट्रांसफर आउटर स्फीयर मैकेनिज्म इज मोस्ट कॉमन इन बायोकेमिस्ट्री एंड बायोमोलिक्यूल. इन बायोकेमिस्ट्री देर आर टू मेन टाइप्स ऑफ द आउटर स्फीयर इलेक्ट्रॉन ट्रांसफर रिएक्शन. इलेक्ट्रॉन ट्रांसफर बिटवीन टू बायोलॉजिकल मॉलिक्यूल. इट इज पॉसिबल दैट द इलेक्ट्रॉन ट्रांसफर टेक प्लेस बिटवीन टू बायोलॉजिकल मॉलिक्यूल एंड द सेकेंड वन इज द इलेक्ट्रॉन ट्रांसफर टेक प्लेस इन अ सिंगल मॉलिक्यूल फ्रॉम वन पार्ट टू द अदर पार्ट. Here these are some questions which you should know how to answer after learning this lecture. Allah Hafiz, have a good time.